Hello, I'm Ron Rouse with Portland Fire and Rescue. Where there's smoke, there's fire. Did you know that more than 2,000 people in the U.S. die every year in residential house fires without working smoke alarms? You have less than 3 minutes to escape a house fire, so the earlier that your alarm alerts you, the more likely that you will survive. There's 3 points that we try to instill in the public. Number one, install. Number two, inspect. And number three, protect. Install the right alarm in the right place. Inspect and test your alarms monthly. Protect your family by having a plan in place. They should know what to do when they hear the alarm. The two most common types of smoke alarms are the ionization and the photoelectric or the optical alarm. Both work on the same principle. There's a battery or a power source, a sensing chamber, and an audible device or a horn. Smoke reaches the chamber and, depending on the type of alarm, disrupts the electrical or light system. Once that continuity is broken, it sends a signal to the audible device, alerting residents to evacuate, thereby saving lives. Let's start with the ionization smoke alarm. In 1968, a guy by the name of Dwayne Pearsall was working on a static control program when he accidentally discovered that, if used in conjunction with radiation, water can be used as a conductor of electricity. Smoke penetrates the current, blocking the electrical charge created by the battery. These are easy to identify by the letter I, the word ionization, or the phrase contains radioactive material. All ionization smoke alarms are required to have a hush feature. This feature silences the alarm for a few minutes. The ability to alarm will return shortly. The photoelectric alarm contains a light source and a photocell. When smoke enters the alarm chamber, a light from the bulb reflects off the smoke particles and is directed toward the photocell, triggering the alarm. These alarms are exempt from the 10-year battery and hush feature requirements, so the battery must be changed every year or when the alarm chirps. There are also combination or dual sensor smoke alarms that sense flaming and smoldering fires. These alarms are identifiable by the words photo and eon, a capital P, a lowercase I, or the phrase photoelectric technology. So where should smoke alarms be installed? Number one, in each bedroom. Number two, outside each sleeping area. And number three, on every level of a home. By placing them on every level of your home, you'll be able to hear one on another floor if your smoke alarms are not hardwired. Remember, time is of the essence. So where should one avoid placing an alarm? Kitchens, garages, and bathrooms. The chance of false alarms is high in these areas. And what do I do if my smoke alarm goes off and there is a fire? Get low and stay out. Crawl under the smoke to your exit. Feel the doorknob before opening the door. And call 911 from outside of your house. Go to your designated meeting place. All alarms should be installed 4 to 12 inches from the ceiling. Never in a corner, because smoke takes too long to accumulate in these pockets. Alarms should be tested weekly, batteries replaced yearly, unless they have the 10-year lithium battery, and replaced every 10 years. Carbon monoxide alarms should be replaced every 5 years. So remember, install, inspect, and protect. And by protect, I mean have a designated meeting place for your family. Fire crews will pull in front of the house, so one person should be available to relay pertinent information. So remember, smoke detectors save lives and double your chance of escaping a fire. Be safe.